today on Las Vegas Now.
Why do we scream at each other? This is what it sounds like when the doves cry.
Today marks the one-year death anniversary of Prince and how fans all over the world are celebrating, plus how you can honor the icon right here in Vegas. Plus, Caesar's songbird Celine Dion opening up about how some of her songs have taken on new meaning over the years. Plus,
you got what I need, but you say he just a friend.
Yes, Biz Markie is in the house and he's bringing the beats.
You're watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
Yeah, Ted, I don't know. I think it's gonna be a high of 80. 79 just seems a little too low.
Here,
so
take it.
Hey guys, I'm Lindsey Simon. Welcome to Las Vegas Now. Kendall and Mercedes are both off. So Ted Florendo is joining me today and I'm invading his weather space.
You are not invading my weather space. Quality time with you? It's good, right?
Yeah, and I respect what you do. It's difficult. I tried one time doing, you know, the weather. I was the blue L is going this way, and the red H is flying all over California.
So
I respect what you do.
By the end of this, you'll get this down.
You'll
be filling in for me.
Doubt it.
Is how it works.
I doubt it. Well, I'll let you do what you do. I'm gonna head over to the Las Vegas Now studio, and I'll see you over there.
Sounds good.
All right.
Co-hosting with you, my pleasure. All right, here's how it looks for the day today. Temperatures, of course, not bad. We're looking in the 70s outside. Notice your winds. We told you in the afternoon those winds would calm down, and those winds now down to less than 10 miles per hour. Still a bit of a breeze in North Las Vegas. Those are north-situated winds, so those areas will still get a bit of a breeze. Here's your evening planner now. Sunny and clear for tonight. Look at that. Your winds also less than 10 for many neighborhoods. Temperatures go from the 70s to low 70s for 8 News Now at 11. It'll be a comfortable night tonight. And for your weekend forecast, looking good. Saturday, again, that hasn't changed. That is your best day, 88 degrees, sunny skies. Your winds, for the most part, stay light and variable. Sunday, 90 degrees. It will be a warm day, but the wind will return on Sunday. We'll have more on that and more on your weekend recreation forecast in just a few minutes at the end of the show. Guys, we'll send it over to you.
Ted, thanks very much. New this afternoon, police are trying to figure out what led up to a shooting near Rancho and the 95.
Now, this happened outside a welfare office. This was the scene just before 11 o'clock in the welfare department parking lot. We're told one man suffered gunshot wounds and was taken to UMC for treatment. No word yet on the extent of those injuries. The suspect was arrested at the scene.
Police have made arrests in that attack on an elderly woman earlier this month, 37-year-old Isaac Almaguer. And 39-year-old Jamie Olivas were arrested. Almaguer charged with battery and burglary. Olivas faces a conspiracy charge, but is out on bail. Earlier this month, the 66-year-old woman was beaten almost to death with what's believed to be a tire iron. Police say she answered her front door at her home near Charleston and Jones around dinner time, and the male suspect attacked her.
We're learning more about the strange animal that sent officers with multiple agencies on a wild chase yesterday. A Metro Police joined animal control officers trying to round up this Patagonian Mara. It's a large rodent native to Argentina, and sometimes they keep it as a pet. And by the time officers got a hold of it, they noticed it was hurt, so it was taken to a vet before going to the Animal Foundation. Witnesses say the animal was dumped from a car nearby, something the Humane Society finds disturbing.
As is so often the case in these situations, they either realize that they could not properly care for the animal, or once the novelty wore off, they simply wanted to get rid of it.
Well, coming up on 8 News Now at 5 and at 6, we'll update you on what's going to happen to this little guy next.
UNLV law students getting a chance to learn from a former U.S. Senator, Harry Reid, officially welcomed to the campus as a distinguished fellow last night.
I can see him, you know, being here and often and actually spending time with students, teaching classes, and just being engaged and just having someone come up to him, you know, to tap him on the shoulder and reach into his wealth of knowledge, I think will be, you know, priceless. You cannot find that any other place in any other university.
Harry Reid will be the first to have such a role at the school. In his new position, he'll work with students and alumni, leading lectures and taking part in other classes. Earlier this year, he was also named co-chair alongside John Boehner. UNLV's new Public Policy Institute.
Well, the Vegas Golden Knights are celebrating a major milestone today.
The final beam is going up at the team's practice facility in Summerlin. John Treach is there now with more on the excitement that is growing. John?
Hey, guys, hard to believe, but this space right here, well, this was just a blank canvas in the desert 6 months ago. October 5th, it was nothing but dirt. Today, obviously, it's a major league structure, 150,000 square feet and counting. Joined right now by Brad Scholda, general manager of the facility. And, my, you've got a lot of work done in 6 months. How proud are you, and how much history has been made today?
Well, this is amazing. I mean, really, all the credit's got to go to Darren Gillette and Gillette Construction. I mean, they told us that we were ahead of schedule, and, you know, we had our doubts just a few weeks ago, and now you come in today and you believe it. And just, you know, for any job site to be ahead of schedule is just, you know, unbelievable, and his crew is amazing.
And you look at what this will do for the community. This is just one sheet of ice behind us. They're also going to have another one for the community and the youth leagues. How unheard of is that for a major league city?
Well, that's is definitely an unheard of, and we're so excited. We can't wait to get open, and the community is going to, you know, really benefit from this as far as us building the game of hockey, and not only hockey, but skating in general, and somewhere for people to, you know, get away from the heat and come into the cold.
Yeah, thank you, Brad, and congratulations. And again, ahead of schedule. They say about 60% done on this project, and they put the last beam today. Commissioner Steve Sisolak, Murray Craven from the Golden Knights was here to honor the occasion. And so congratulations to our first Major League franchise. We're making history today. Reporting live, John Treach, 8 Sports Now.
History fast, too. And that's all for the news for now. We will be back at 5 o'clock and a full hour of 8 News Now at 6 o'clock.
Let's send it back to Lindsey and Ted for now.
All right, thanks, guys. Thanks for coming over.
This is great. It's a whole different world in this studio.
It's like home.
Yeah, it really is.
Welcome to our home.
I've got the CNN high-tech looking Discovery, you know, Discovery Channel looking set over there. And then here, I'm closer to the kitchen.
So and look, light even comes through the window.
Yeah, magically.
All right, well, let's get to your local entertainment headlines. If you liked HGTV's Flip or Flop, then you'll love the new spinoff, which takes place right here in Las Vegas. The show Flip or Flop Vegas just premiered this month, and this weekend, you'll have the chance to meet the stars in person. MMA fighter Bristol Morandi and his wife Aubrey will be at Tivoli Village's design showcase tomorrow and answering questions from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. The first 200 guests get a $10 gift card to use at any Tivoli Village restaurant.
Nice.
Do you like those types of shows, like renovation shows?
I watch them because my wife watches them religiously.
Mm-hmm.
So I stand by and be a good husband and watch them with her.
That's good for you. That's a good job.
Right. The latest one, that couple split, but this couple, this is in Vegas.
Yeah. And they're going to be doing, I think, 13 cities of, you know, these spin-off channels. So you can meet them tomorrow.
Cannot wait. You lost me at the gift card at Tivoli Village.
Yeah, $10.
Yeah. All right. Today marks the one-year anniversary of Prince's death. And to pay tribute, fans all over the world are celebrating the star. 4 days of events are planned at his Paisley Park home, which was turned into a museum in Minneapolis. That's where he grew up. Also glowing in purple lights to honor Prince. Locally, the Westgate Las Vegas is celebrating Purple Rain Month with promotions, discount tickets, and giveaways. Prince died from a drug overdose at his Minnesota home. The medical examiner ruled it an accident. Police are still investigating the circumstances surrounding his death.
And on the heels of getting his very own Las Vegas residency, Ricky Martin is also getting his own reality show.
Of course.
Of course, just like every other celebrity. Well, VH1 says the series will give fans a look inside how the star prepared for his park theater performances right here in Vegas. So that would be cool to see. According to Entertainment Weekly, the show, which is set to debut in June, will be a, quote, never-been-seen account of one of the most private and guarded global superstars of our time. Now, by the way, Ricky is also set to play Giovanni Versace's lover, Antonio D'Amico.
Oh, really?
In, the FX show Versace American Crime Story. So he's a busy guy.
Yeah. Have you seen his show yet?
I'm supposed to go.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I still have yet to go, but I can't wait to see it.
It's gonna be a fun show.
He's been around for so long, and he's remained so popular throughout, like since the 90s.
Yeah.
No, 80s.
It's 80s. We remember him in the 90s. He still looks exactly the same. And he's got the whitest teeth out of anybody I've ever seen.
Him and Christy Brinkley, I think they sold their souls.
Yeah, right.
There's no amount of water and healthy eating.
I want to know their secret ASAP, right? From Latin pop stars to hard rock ragers, The guys from Godsmack are walking into the studio right now. Hey, fellas. Wait till you hear what the band was originally called and the funny story behind it all. Godsmack in studio.
And, oh, baby, you got what I want. You definitely don't want to miss our interview with the beat master himself, Biz Markie.
Nice.
It's all coming up on Las Vegas Now.
The 7-day forecast on 8 News Now is sponsored by Valley Auto Mall.
The dealer now.
Today on 8 News Now at 5, it's the chase everyone's talking about. So where is this little guy now? Plus, taxes, file, refund on its way. But what this guy got next has him asking Michelle about a possible new scam on 8 News Now at 5.
That's just one of the many hits Godsmack has had over the years. The rock band is headlining one of Las Vegas' newest festivals, Las Rageous. And today, Godsmack lead singer Sully Erna and drummer Shannon Larkin are joining us to give us the scoop. So welcome to Las Vegas.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Although it's not your first time here, I'm sure. I understand you're a pretty big poker player.
Or was at one point.
Was? You were in the World Series of poker.
A few times. Yeah, I did well. I had a good run for a few years, and then I started touring again and getting involved back into making money instead of losing money. So I had to, you know, lay it down for a little bit. But I had a good run for a bit.
When you play, do you have any, like, do you wear your hat a specific way, or do you wear sunglasses?
I wear the hat down and the sunglasses because, you know, a lot of even my friends are pro poker players, and although they've helped groom me and help my game a lot, when I go against them, I don't want them to get any reads, so I try to go, you know, Kenny from South Park.
Yeah, hide it all.
Exactly.
Well, Shannon, when you're here in town, what do you like to do? Are you at the poker table as well?
No. I'm not a big gambler, but I like to shop. I like Barbados. I always hit the Barbados shop. And food, you know, it's always vibrant and exciting to be in Las Vegas.
Absolutely. And you guys are here for the Las Rageous Festival, the first annual. How has it been so far? I mean, there's a lot of prep, you're headlining, that's exciting.
Yeah, it's always, I mean, it's funny, Vegas was always one of the first markets for us that lit up, even when we were playing to nobody in the clubs. There was just a few places, obviously Boston, our hometown, you know, Vegas and certain places like that were kind of the first on the map. So we've always had a good welcome here when we come through. As far as this venue goes tonight, we haven't played it yet. I think it's the first time that they're doing it at this location.
Right.
So, but I hear it's doing well and there's a lot of great bands on it.
And do you want to tell everyone where the location is?
I don't know.
No.
It's downtown, I know that. The old Vegas, I hear.
Downtown Center? Does that sound right?
Maybe.
Downtown Event Center?
So the big
You're like,
field
I don't know.
Somewhere.
Someone drives me there and we show
no,
up.
No, it's
play.
Outdoors, so it's.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so
it's
maybe
gonna
that's
be cool.
It. Yeah.
And I want to talk, you guys, obviously Godsmack, but you have these side projects, each of you, and the sounds are very different than what you do at Godsmack. Is that difficult? Is it something like you have a blues album? Is that something you've always wanted to do, or?
Yeah, you know, we grew up, our blues was Zeppelin, you know, it's not like we were Sonny Boy Williams or whatever, but, and so, you know, I discovered through writing for Godsmack that Tony Rombola, our guitar player, is a fantastic blues player, mm-hmm. which I didn't know, so I'm like, I'm gonna start a band. And, you know, and Sully has his solo thing, and they're completely different animals than Godsmack is, so gives us another outlet.
Yeah.
Because you know, Godsmack, you know, we tour really hard, and then we take a big break.
Mm-hmm.
And in those big breaks, you know.
We tour some more.
Yeah, we tour more with our side things and get that yah-yah out.
And I read that the original name of Godsmack was The Scam.
Right.
So what is the story behind that?
Well, because when we were first starting out, see, I was a drummer my whole life. I played for numerous bands. That's actually how I met Shannon. He was playing for a band called Wrathchild.
Okay.
I was playing with some different bands, and we met each other in the Carolinas, and we just became friends and stayed in touch. And then as I kind of got sick of following someone else's direction, I decided one day I was gonna start my own project and do it my way.
Mm-hmm.
At that time, I was learning a bit more guitar and stuff like that, so I started writing my own songs, and we put this band together. And we couldn't get a gig because we were brand new. No mm-hmm. one knew of us. So what we would do sometimes, we would show up, I hope this is incriminating to say this, but we would show up at the clubs before the opening act would show up. We'd always try to get a gig where there was like a good national or someone headlining, so we knew there'd be a good crowd. And then we would show up at the clubs, and we would wait for the opening band to show up. And when they would show up, we'd be like, hey, you guys, we'd pretend we work for the club. We'd be like, you're late, beat it. And then the club owner would come out eventually and be like, where's the opening band? We're like, I don't know, but we're a band, we can
do it. Oh my gosh.
And we'd scam our way into some of these gigs. And so we just became the scam. And then, you know, eventually the anything at that time was a little dated. Uh-huh. So we eventually switched the name. But yeah, that's the story behind
it. Oh my gosh. And then Godsmack, was that just, how did that come about?
Well, Godsmack was another funny story. It was actually, when we were looking for a new name, we were, again, not signed. We didn't have any money. We were playing for like, you know, $20 and a case of beer.
Yeah.
The drummer, the original drummer, showed up one day to do a photo shoot that we'd already paid for. And we couldn't get the money back, and he showed up with a big cold sore on his lip. And so, of course, me being, you know, the wise guy that I am, I was like, you know, that's what you get for kissing other men and blah, blah, blah. And eventually I ragged on him all day, and the next day I showed up, he did the photo shoot, and the next day I showed up with a big cold sore on my lip, same spot, same size, and my guitar player, Tony's like, see, God just smacked you for making fun of him yesterday.
Oh my gosh, that's how it came about?
And that's how God
smacked me. It's like karmic retribution.
Yeah.
So if you make fun of someone for their hair falling out, your hair starts falling out, that's a God smack.
Oh, wow, I love that, I never knew.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. You guys are performing tonight, correct, at Las Rages?
Yes.
Okay, well, check out these guys, along with Avenged Sevenfold, Anthrax, and many more at the Las Rages Festival, happening tonight and tomorrow at the Downtown Events Center. Well, some are saying our favorite California girl is looking more and more like a famous chef. Coming up, a look at Katy Perry's twinning moment and how she's getting in on the joke. Plus, Las Vegas headliner Celine Dion opens up about her late husband and which song has new meaning for her. Hey everyone, welcome back to Las Vegas Now. Your bill for your internet is like riding a roller coaster sometimes, it seems. Well, constantly going up and down, but what if you paid one price for life? Jason Chan from CenturyLink is here with all of the details. Thank you for coming in, Jason.
Thanks for having me.
So first, can you explain what CenturyLink does? What do you guys do over there?
Absolutely. We're your one-stop shop for all of your communications needs. Okay. So whether that's TV, your internet, or your phone, we can take care of all of it for you.
Okay, and let's talk about this one plan for life.
Absolutely. So our new price for life promotion is really exciting. We've heard the consumers, you know, talk about, you know, no one likes getting surprises on their bills, that you sign up for one price and then a couple months down the road or a year down the road, the promotion rolls off and the bill jumps up. Nobody likes that surprise. And we said, let's make it easy for the consumers. Let's make it one price, make it for life, and make sure that it doesn't change. And so that's the new promotion that we're rolling out this month.
Okay, and yeah, like you said, people wanted this, you came out with it, and what is the price? Are you able to talk about that?
Yeah, so our intro price is $40 for up to 25 megs, and then we actually have speed tiers. So if you have a need for speed, we actually can go faster, and it basically adds basically $20 or $10 for the next tier and then up and up. Just depending on how fast of the internet you need.
Wow.
Yeah, and then the other thing we realized, in addition to not wanting a price to jump, is that we wanted to make it really easy from the first instance you have with us that the install's free. That, you know, we have fantastic technicians that know the products inside and out. And, you know, when it comes to tech, you know, when I look at, you know, my own family, my dad, my mom, my wife, et cetera, you look at the cables and you say, what do I do with this?
Right.
We've got techs that are trained that have been doing it year after year that know how to do it. And we want to go ahead and make sure that you have that fantastic install experience, absolutely complimentary as a result of joining the CenturyLink family.
Very good. So no installation fee. Are there kind of hidden fees like you're going to add on for us? So
well,
it's actually more like 75 per month.
That's the whole point of the promotion, because that's what people are used to.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, wanting to get away from those whammies or gotchas, mm-hmm. $40 is $40. Uncle Sam still adds on, you know, we just paid our taxes. Mm-hmm. They still want to add the taxes to that $40. But from our perspectives, there's no additional fees on top of that. So you get the free install, a great deal, and that price that won't change for life.
Wow, this is great, because there are a few months out of the year that we just turn every, you know, even our bills, I don't remember them ever being $40. So
yeah.
That's amazing.
Absolutely.
All right.
We're really excited about it. And you want to know how to sign up?
Yeah.
Yeah, so give us a call at 702-244-7770. Make sure to mention my name. They'll be sure to take care of you. And we welcome you to the family.
Well, thank you. And his name is Jason, so make sure to mention Jason.
Mention Jason, 702-244-7770, or visit us on our website at CenturyLink.com.
All right, very good. Thank you. Well, KFC got a cool new kernel.
The time has come to explore beyond our known horizons.
Yeah, find out who the face is behind the chicken, if you can't already guess. And Biz Markie in the house. We're talking to the Beat Master next.
Jeopardy.
You're watching Las Vegas Now with Lindsey Simon, Kendall Tenney, and Mercedes Martinez.
You got what I need, but you say he just a friend, and you say he just a friend. Oh, baby, you got what I need.
How does that song has to make everyone happy.
Oh, yeah.
That is a classic, Just a Friend by Biz Markie, and he joins us now with more on where he's performing in Vegas this weekend, and during that, he's playing the keys on the table, reenacting it.
Oh, yeah.
You still got it? You still remember all of it?
I remember everything. I'm an elephant when it comes to memory.
Well, first tell people where you're performing.
I am performing at the House of Blues, 80s versus 90s, When Decades Collide Tour. You know, we play all the good 80s and 90s. We got two bands, the best bands from the area. Some do 80s, some do 90s. And I DJ in between and I perform in between. But you know, I'm the headliner and we're going to have some fun. Come down there to have some fun. It's going to be beautiful.
I want to know because Just a Friend came out in 1989.
Yeah.
Wow. And so you're doing the 80s versus 90s. But how does the hip hop, community, how has it changed from the 80s and 90s to today? In your opinion?
I think we were more passionate back then, more real passionate about it. And we was more passionate about being different. We ain't trying to sound like nobody else. Mm-hmm. We wasn't trying to dress like nobody else. If you look at any of my videos, I always dress different than anybody.
And Ted, I'm sorry I'm hogging this anyway. I just have a lot of questions.
Get him in. I got time. I came here a day early just to get the questions on.
This video here, this is the best.
It's awesome. Well, our social media guru, Nikki, was talking with you during commercial break. And was that on Facebook Live, Nikki?
Yes.
Okay, and she asked you, you know, how some of the bands differentiate. And you just did like a full blown performance. Can you give our viewers a little bit of.
Well, rest in peace to Buffy, you know what I mean? But like Buffy from Fat Boy. He likes to do sounds with it, you know, like. Dougie Fresh is, you know, that's my partner and everything, but Dougie Fresh is.
Oh my gosh.
Me, I do a lot of sounds together. Like, I go, my name is Biz Markie, the human ong.
Did you know this as a kid that you were this talented, or is this something that just started gradually?
I was a different type of kid, so I mean, like, I used to collect People magazines and toys and everything, so I was a different type of kid. I was a smart kid in school, but I always was a class clown. But when I made up the beatbox, I knew that because I didn't have toys and stuff like everybody else. So instead of having my own piano, I play my own piano with my mouth, or drums, you know, like,
jeez.
Or a snare, like a boo, 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 or k, 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 or t, 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 or. So I would put it all together. So whatever record was out, I used to play it with my mouth.
Wow, that's unbelievable.
Have you seen the video? Sorry, Ted.
That's right.
I have more questions.
Let her go. Let her go.
Have you seen this video of Alicia Keys' son beatboxing?
Oh, no.
Okay, well, we have it, I do think. Our producer, Selena, do we have the video? Okay, watch this.
Hey. Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
So So what do you think? Hey. He's the next generation Pismo.
Oh, yeah, he could be the next generation. But a lot of the kids is learning it from a show that I was on called Yo Gabba Gabba. So okay. I used to do Biz Beat of the Day, and little kids will learn, because I do Biz Beat of the Day, and I tell the kids, go, boo, ah, boo, boo, ah, and you see the kids go, boo, ah, boo. I mean, if you ever see the live show, it's in the show, so you know.
Okay, so that's what he's doing. Very cool.
That's unbelievable. Wow. Now, do you have any advice for anybody else that wants to get in the business? I mean, there's a lot of people out there probably want to jump in like this.
People that want to get in the rap business, beatbox, whatever, you got to believe in yourself. Yeah. You can't let nobody deter you. And you just got to practice. It's all about practicing and mastering your craft.
Well, I have to say, we actually saw you last summer. You were performing somewhere, and my husband was very excited to meet you. You were very nice to him. You took a picture with him, and I have to show it because it's so... Look, do you remember that face?
Oh, I remember that. That's, I was DJing at a party at a foundation group.
Yes. Do you remember him? Is he...
Look at that face. How could you...
Yeah, that... I will remember that face.
So thank you for being very nice to him and taking a picture with him. You made his night. All right, you can catch Biz Markie over at the House of Blues, Las Vegas, tomorrow night. It's the 80s versus 90s show.
When Decades Collide Tour.
Very good. Well, tickets just $15.
Yeah, because we're not trying to kill. We just want people to come out and have fun.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, I'm sure they will. Doors open at 7. All right, still to come on Las Vegas Now, musicians can be inspired by just about anyone. Which celebrity Katy Perry is channeling with her new look?
Vegas headliner Celine Dion opens up about losing her husband, how she finds comfort in one of her biggest hits. And here's today's fun trivia. What was Prince's nickname when he was growing up? We'll tell you after the break. Stick around.
Chevy is the...
Monday on Good Day.
A healthy lifestyle for adults may begin as a child.
Tips for parents to create children who grow into adults who may pass on the unhealthy snacks.
And the mayor of North Las Vegas joining us in studio.
He's answering your questions Monday on Good Day.
His trivia question, what was Prince's nickname when he was growing up? His nickname? Skipper. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
Interesting.
Figured it was...
You learn something new every day.
Symbol?
Just the symbol.
Sorry for hogging the interview.
It's okay.
I had a lot of questions. I really like him.
You do a good job, so I just let you go.
Thank you.
You know, you're used to that? Well, as a journalist, I am too. But I said, you know, she's on a roll, so I'm just going to let her go. Go for it.
Well, I appreciate it. All right, well, we're taking a look at some stories trending right now, starting with Katy Perry and the new do that has everyone buzzing on social media. Have you seen this?
I have not seen this.
The pop star recently debuted her new hairdo, which is a platinum blonde pixie.
No.
Some were saying it looked extremely similar to celebrity chef Guy Fieri's hairdo. So what does Katy do? She joins in on the joke by posting a side-by-side of her and Fieri on Instagram saying, quote, National Lookalike Day.
What happened? She's still pretty.
I don't think she wears it. Carlos, our floor director, is going, eh-eh.
Yeah, it's not working for you, huh? You and me,
Long
too.
Brunette.
Right.
She's
still pretty, don't get me wrong. But, you know, she's not pulling off that look.
I think she usually, like, does this a little bit.
Oh,
like,
yeah, just kind of does the...
Which is cute. I mean, Miley Cyrus had that. It works.
Yeah, it might work.
Katy, you look gorgeous no matter what your hair looks like.
Nothing wrong at all, Katy. Keep it up. Keep up the good work. By the way, Guy Fieri, you an OB alum, too.
Did not know that.
Just so you know. Yep. If you think Colonel Sanders in the KFC commercial looks a little different recently, well, you're right. Take a look.
There is one question that we will be able to answer with certainty very soon. Can you actually
succeed? Hi, guys. Rob Lowe is now Colonel Sanders. The company is promoting its new Zinger sandwich. Lowe joins a long list of celebs who have played the iconic Colonel, such as George Hamilton, Norm MacDonald, and Jim Gaffigan. Now, I'm sorry, Jim Gaffigan again?
Oh, comedian. He's one of my faves.
Really? I'm trying to remember the name.
Hot Pockets.
Oh, okay, there we go. All right, that's all you guys had to say. That's all you needed. It just jogged my memory.
All them C-Levs. Rob Lowe, gosh. Handsome and incredibly funny.
Yeah, still just to this day.
God spent a little more time on him. Well, Celine Dion's My Heart Will Go On served as the theme song to the 1997 box office hit Titanic. Mm-hmm. But now, since losing her husband last year, Celine says the song has taken on a new meaning for her.
And when my husband passed, it became, probably for the first time, our song. Mm-hmm. And when I sing it, I used to sing it for the fans. And now I sing it for us. But when I look at the fans, they look at me and they know that I sing it for him.
Mm-hmm. Well, wow. That interview is from ITV's Lorraine. Celine also says that Renee will never leave her. Not only is he in her heart, but he performs with her as well. I just love her. I absolutely adore her. She's such a classy woman. She was at Magic, revealing her new line. She's got a handbag line and luggage line. And she honestly sang everything.
Really?
Like, she answered questions in song.
Wow.
I think it's just, I love her.
You could tell, too, the love between those two. I mean, it was for endless time, you know? So they've been together a long time. Mm-hmm. Coming up next on Las Vegas Now, the annual AIDS Walk of Las Vegas is this Sunday. Who's performing and how much money have they found? Oh, have they found out? What next? The music. Go back. Find out next what musical group will be at the fundraiser.
The Weather Guy. What another reason to help save the planet. We have tips on how you can keep the earth clean and stay green at the same time.
I don't have a problem. I never use a problem.
Furniture for Las Vegas Now.
Ted Florendo, everybody. I don't know why I said it like Saturday Night Live.
That was a really good intro.
I don't know where that came from.
You have a new calling, I think. New voiceover work. All right. That was a snort.
Yeah,
there too.
Sorry.
All right. That's not in closed captioning. Snort. It's one of the Valley's longest running fundraisers with some of our city's biggest celebrities helping out. I'm talking about AFAN's AIDS Walk. This is the 27th year of the walk. Several celebrities will be lending a hand to raise awareness, including America's Got Talent, Tate Face. He was in here, right?
Yes, he was.
The Chippendales, and of course, Human Nature. The fundraiser is the organization's biggest one of the year.
This is exactly what keeps us running, because for us, having the AIDS Walk and other events throughout the year allows us to really provide the services at a full scale. You know, with the amount of clients that we see, the amount of visits that we see, and the requests that we get on a daily basis about services for emergency and all of those things.
Last year, they had more than 5,000 participants and raised more than $350,000. Wow.
Yeah, the AFAN AIDS Walk is this Sunday, April 23rd, taking place at Town Square. For more information, you can visit AFAN's website, which is right there on your screen, afanlv.org.
Nice. Now, if you do yoga, you know all about the poses like the warrior, the downward dog, and the bow pose. But have you seen this pose? How the man popped the question? That's next on Las Vegas Now.
But first, tomorrow is Earth Day and my birthday. Just to make
it happen. You hear that, guys? So you know.
I accept diamonds. And Republic Services is encouraging everyone to take the One More Pledge and commit to one more act to help preserve our planet. Now, here are three ways you can do it. First, make sure recyclables are empty, clean, and dry before placing them in a recycling container. Mm-hmm. Also, learn about electronics recycling solutions to make sure your old gadgets are being recycled safely. And finally, help your workplace recycle items like batteries and bulbs, which should never be thrown away with regular waste.
Good advice.
We'll be right back.
If there's a visit your local Acura dealer today.
Hey, Sonia. Hey, Devin. Sonia helps with our guests. She's part of our sales team, and Devin runs the camera and helps with my mic pack when I can't reach it on my back of my dress. Well, you may have already signed up for Medicare, but now is the time to learn more about your plan's benefits so you can save money and stay healthy throughout the year. Gary Denning from United Healthcare is here with why it's an important time for people to think about their Medicare coverage. So thanks for coming in.
Thank you for having me. You know, millions of people had the opportunity to select their Medicare coverage
coverage during the open, the annual election period or open enrollment period last fall. Mm-hmm. And many of them chose original Medicare, but most of them did choose a Medicare Advantage plan. Medicare Advantage plans include original Medicare, which is parts A and B, rolled together, and also offer additional benefits like prescription drug costs and additional benefits like, you know, dental, vision, health coverage as well.
Okay, and what advice do you have to help people make the most out of
their plan? Well, what's really important today to talk about is, you know, when you chose your plan last fall, many times we have senior moments and we forget what the coverage includes. Mm-hmm. And so we really want individuals to take out their policies and look at and understand what is included. On original Medicare, for example, there are health screenings that are covered in an annual wellness visit. With Medicare Advantage, you have not only those benefits, but also vision, dental, and hearing, gym memberships. So these are additional benefits that can really help folks be healthy and happy and more active. And that's important. It also can help you save money.
And what about those with a fixed income? I mean, we know every dollar counts. How can people plan for their health care spending?
Right. So cost continues to rise. And with original Medicare, it covers 80% of your medical costs, which leaves the 20% for the individual to cover on their own without any annual maximum out of pocket. But Medicare Advantage plans do have a maximum out of pocket as well as reliable co-pays that they can count on. And so understanding what the costs are and then saving for those and being prepared can help you to have coverage all year long.
And of course, drug costs, you know, prescriptions, mm-hmm. that's difficult.
Yes.
What advice would you give for those people that do have prescriptions that need to be filled?
Right. Now, people need to remember that on original Medicare, there is no drug coverage, and so you have to pay for those drugs on your own unless you get a prescription drug plan. On a Medicare Advantage plan, most do include the prescription drug plan as well. And how you save money on those plans is by using mail order. Many of them offer 90 to 100 days at a discounted price. If you do want to go to a retail store, many of the drug plans work specifically with different retail stores where they give you bigger discounts. So
okay.
You can really save some money by choosing where you're getting those drugs.
Okay, well, that was a lot of helpful information. I'm sure you have a lot more information. Where can people go to get this information?
Yes, on the web, you can go to MedicareMadeClear.com, also Medicare.gov, and if you'd like to call 1-800-MEDICARE, those are great places. You can also refer to your plan and get the information from them. The number on the back of their card will give you that phone number.
Okay, well, thank you so much for coming in and for the helpful advice, and we will be right back.
Today on 8 News Now at 5, it's the chase everyone's talking about. So where is this little guy now? Bus, taxes, filed, refund on its way. But what this guy got next has him asking Michelle about a possible new scam on 8 News Now at 5. Source.
8 News Now at 5 starts here in just a few minutes. Here's why you should stick around. We are learning more about the victims of Wednesday's stabbing spree. The man who died, a father of three. We'll take a look at how he's being remembered today, as well as new details about the night of the arrest. Tax season may be over for most of us, but tax scam season has just begun for all of us. Consumer advocate Michelle Mortensen has one that you're going to want to be aware of. And it's a story that reached hundreds of thousands of people across the country yesterday. We broke the news right here on 8 News Now. The little critter that had Las Vegas law enforcement on a wild chase yesterday afternoon spent the night at the vet's office. We're checking in to see where little guy's headed next. Coming up in just a few minutes right here on 8 News Now. Right now, let's get another weather update from Ted.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you very much. Of course, what do you think of the weather outside? Nice?
Very nice. Yeah.
Scale from 1 to 10. What do you give it?
Well, you know I blame you anytime anything goes wrong.
We're such good friends. You know that. All right, here's how it looks tonight, all right? The good news, those winds we had earlier, they're decreasing right now. We told you that they would be less than 10 tonight. Of course, we're going to see that. Clear and calmer tonight, 62 degrees for your low. Some northern neighborhoods will still see a bit of a breeze tonight. All right, we're talking Aliante, North Las Vegas, Centennial Hills. You'll still see some of a breeze, but it looks great tomorrow. 88 degrees, sunny and warmer. Beautiful day tomorrow, Lindsey, with those winds about 5 to 15 in some spots, but we do expect some breezes still down the Colorado River and the lake. So if you're going boating tomorrow, keep in mind that we will still have some gusty winds down there. So windy on Sunday. Tomorrow looks good. Look at that. 90s and 80s for next week. You're welcome.
I concur. I agree with that forecast.
You're welcome.
Do. Yes, thank you. Okay. Well, the couple that does yoga together stays together. As a couple practiced some serious yoga moves on a beach in Hawaii, and he balanced her on two legs. And she looks down, and there he is holding a ring. Whoa, be careful. She was surprised. And she said yes, while staying perfectly balanced.
She's very poised.
You missed the part where she fell. Oh, good for them. That's cute.
She didn't cry at all. That was pretty good.
She just bent all the way back for a Spider-Man kiss. That was cute. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Ted, thanks for being my co-host.
It is my pleasure. It was fun.
It was fun.
Thank you for having me.
All right, have a great weekend. We'll see you back here on Monday.
What?